Coming up, we show you the new MBR2GPT disk conversion tool that's part of the Windows 10 Creators Update. We show you how you can safely convert a Windows 10 machine from legacy BIOS to UEFI disk partitioning, and how you can automate the conversion as part of your in-place upgrade process from Windows 7 to Windows 10, all without having to move your data off the disk. Windows 10 includes a number of important security features such as Secure Boot, which protects the startup process from malicious software, Device Guard, which gives you advanced controls for application access, and Credential Guard, which helps prevent pass-the-hash attacks. But to get the benefits of these features, you need a device which supports the Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, aka UEFI. If you're not familiar with UEFI, it's an interface between the operating system and the platform firmware. It replaces BIOS, which has been around for decades and has many limitations. And using UEFI means faster startup, shutdown, sleep, and resume times. To make the shift to UEFI, the best option is to deploy Windows 10 in UEFI mode from the get-go. But if you have already deployed Windows 10 in BIOS mode on UEFI-capable machines, or if you're looking to do an in-place upgrade from Windows 7, there are two things you have to do to adopt UEFI. First, you need to convert the disk from using the master boot record partition style, or MBR, to using the GUID partition table partition style, or GPT, which is required to run Windows in UEFI mode. Next, you need to reconfigure your firmware from BIOS mode to UEFI mode, either using tools from the PC manufacturers or changing the settings manually in the firmware menu. MBR2GPT is available with the Creators Update for Windows 10 and the Windows pre-installation environment. Let me explain how the conversion works. The tool enables partition style conversion in minutes and is a non-destructive process. In the past, you would have to spend hours backing up your data to another location, repartition the disk, reinstall Windows, and then restore the data. With MBR2GPT, the conversion is done by applying the GPT components to an MBR disk without modifying the existing partitions and file systems, allowing the data to remain intact. First, let's look at how we can use the tool on a system that's already running Windows 10. Here's the machine that I've been using for some time and have personalized. And in disk management, let's look at the properties of the system disk. And under volumes, we can see that the system disk is currently using the master boot record partition style. To perform the conversion, I've booted the same system into Windows PE. The MBR2GPT tool is located under the system32 directory, and you can see the usage information with a command line help option. In this case, everything checks out. But if the disk didn't meet requirements, for example, maybe the disk was already GPT, the tool would return an error. Next, I'm going to actually convert the disk using the convert option. This will typically shrink the Windows partition and create a new system partition in the freed up space. Let's kick off the conversion from MBR2GPT. As you can see here, the conversion takes only a few seconds, compared to hours if I had gone with the wipe and reinstall approach. With the disk converted to GPT, the next step is to change the firmware mode by rebooting the system into the firmware settings menu. In this example, I need to change the firmware option from legacy only to pure UEFI. But the settings will vary by PC manufacturer and even by machine models. Now I've booted the machine back into Windows 10, notice that my files and customizations have not changed, and that's because the conversion is non-destructive. But if I look at disk management, I can see that the disk has actually been converted to GPT. And system information also shows that Windows is now booted in UEFI mode and Secure Boot is enabled. Next, let's look at how we can automate the disk conversion as part of a Windows 7 to Windows 10 in-place upgrade. The MBR2GPT conversion tool can be integrated with task sequence-based deployment tools such as System Center Configuration Manager or the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit. In this case, we'll use MDT and look at the steps added to an upgrade task sequence. After the upgrade the operating system phase, we've added a task group called Convert, which does a few things. First, it runs a script that enables UEFI-only mode in the firmware, which is needed for Secure Boot to work. Then, in the Convert MBR2GPT task, the MBR2GPT tool is run from within Windows 10 using the Convert and Allow Full OS options. And finally, in the Finish action step, we reboot the machine once the conversion is done. Now let's move to our Windows 7 machine and run the task sequence we just looked at. Again, in disk management, I can see that the disk is currently using MBR partition style. Next, we will kick off the deployment wizard. We will select the task sequence we looked at earlier. Here I've predefined a password. And in this case, I'm not going to enable BitLocker. And finally, we'll begin the upgrade. This will take a few minutes, and we'll upgrade the system to Windows 10 and run our three custom tasks. With the machine upgraded to Windows 10, let's look at disk management again. Here we can see that the disk was successfully converted to GPT. And in system information, we can see that Windows 10 is now booting in UEFI mode and secure boot is enabled. A couple of things to keep in mind when using MBR to GPT. If you're converting a disk with BitLocker enabled, make sure that you suspend protection first. And to resume protection after conversion, you need to remove the existing protectors and recreate them. An MBR disk can have at most 4 primary partitions, so the disk you want to convert should have up to 3 partitions so that the tool can create a new EFI system partition. Also, while you can run the tool from the full Windows 10 environment and convert the disk it's booted from, you might encounter problems due to interferences from other applications. As such, we recommend running the tool offline from Windows PE. You can learn more about how the tool works and how to troubleshoot issues at the link below. We hope this overview of the new disk conversion tool helps you harness the benefits of UEFI faster. Keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates for Windows management and deployment. Thanks for watching.